Welcome our first guest on the show. Beverage company Tilaknagar Industries has reported a strong set in their first quarter. Importantly, the balance sheet improved as well as their margins expanded. We have Amit Dhanukar, who's the CMD of the company, joining us now. Thanks a lot, Mr. Dhanukar, for joining in. With your debt now reduced, what are the plans with the free cash flows? I remember the last conversation we had, you said that you will use operational cash flows to fund business growth itself. Is there a chance of shareholders being rewarded with the excess cash flow, say, in the form of dividend or any sort of buyback, etc.?
So I will come to your first question, you know, regarding the debt reduction. I think the debt reduction journey has been steady since 2019, when our gross debt peaked at levels of 1,200 crores, and it was down to 250 crores as of March 31st. We have further reduced it further this quarter. In fact, the debt which we had from the ARC, that has been completely extinguished. As of June 30th, we had 176 crores of debt from the ARC, which has now been totally extinguished. We had Kotak refinance the ARC debt. They came in with 130 crores, and the balance 46 crores was funded out of the company's internal accruals. Interest costs also have been on the decline. 2 years ago, our quarterly interest was around 15 crores, and we saw in the first quarter the interest cost is approximately 6 crores. So a steep reduction in finance cost, I think that will help the company going forward.
Hi, Amit. Good morning. Amit, so as you said, the interest cost has come down drastically to around 6 crores. Now, post this refinancing, will it hold at around 6 crores or will it be a little lower or higher?
So, Nigel, I am expecting it for this year. It should hold around 6 crores. And going forward, next year, we would expect it to reduce by around 50%. So, okay, for this year, our finance cost estimate is between 20 to 25 odd crores. And then we expect a steeper reduction in the next financial year.
And you'll become net debt-free by March 2025, right?
Yes, we intend to, absolutely. And we are on track for that, Nigel.
Okay, all right. Amit, you know, beyond the debt position, since you have it pretty much under control, from 1,200 crores, it's come down, I think, by close to 80% to 90% from the peak. The street would like to know about diversifying beyond brandy. Mm-hmm. You know, that's going to be the trigger out there. So could you tell us, how do you see your mix shape up? I think as of now, 93-94% still comes in from brandy. And I think one of the gins,
yes,
that you have, the pink gin, Samsara. Oh, it's a,
yes,
it's a very good one. I,
yes,
think that's
Samsara,
part of your kitty as well. Samsara. Yeah, I think you all had picked up a minority stake in that company, which,
yes,
is very, very good, I think. So, and it's catching everyone's attention as well. But how do you plan on diversifying? Because this focus on brandy will not really meet what the street is expecting from you.
So, Nigel, you know, we are a brandy-first company. I think, as you have correctly pointed out, 95% of our volumes do come from brandy. We have a leadership position in this category. Mansion House brandy, of course, is the largest selling premium brandy in India, the second largest selling brandy globally. We also had last year one of our other brandy brands, Courier Napoleon, that has also become a millionaire brand, selling more than a million cases. So very strong position in brandy. And I don't think in the immediate term there's going to be any defocus from brandy. I think we are still seeing ample opportunities to grow the brandy category itself. I think the brandy industry grew by around 13% last year. So the industry is growing quite reasonably. I think we are making deeper inroads in our market share in brandy. We had an industry-first innovation in Flandy, which was the flavored brandy, which we introduced in two states last year. And we've just launched it in Andhra Pradesh this year. We're getting a good response. And so we will remain in the near term focused on brandy. But I think going forward, if I was to give any guidance, I would say,
yes,
that, say, in the next 4 to 5 years, we would see the other newer products contributing around 20 to 25% of the portfolio over a five-year horizon.
Over a five-year horizon, 20 to 25%. And will it be...
It would come from non-brandy.
Yes. So will it be gin? Will it be vodka? Will it be... What other spirit would it be? Because Samsara, you know, you have just 10% stake. You'll obviously have to increase,
yes,
it at some point, right?
So I would not... Yes, Samsara, we do have a 10% stake. It's the, you know, the Samsara also was an industry-first innovation. I think they were the first ones to come out with the pink gin. And it's the fastest-growing craft gin in India today. So it's a very interesting gin, and it's been growing month on month. Yes, we do have a 10% stake in Samsara. I think going forward, I think it would be very early to make any presumptions in terms of increasing our stake or otherwise, but we do have participation in that category.
Okay.
So we also have a entry level gin which we have launched, Blue Lagoon Gin, which we have just introduced in the East and the Northeast. So in terms of the diversification strategy, we are just seeding the market right now. I think it's very early days, but the balance sheet is much more robust now to subscribe to these opportunities.
Okay.
So it's gin basically, it's diversification.
It's a little too early actually to talk about this, I think at 10:30 in the morning on Monday. But, you know, gin, that vodka as well with a little bit of a fruity taste is what you all have launched. But let's keep that aside.
Well,
focus
well
on a couple
gin,
of...
gin is an afternoon drink, Nigel. So it's not too early.
You know, the markets are on. We're not going to be looking at that. But anyways, we came out of a weekend. So, you know, we get the mood. But tell us, give us a couple of numbers. Your 40% volume growth is very good in an industry, which is actually not growing too much. Could you tell us the number of cases, million cases? Can you do around 13 million cases for this year, FY24?
So I think, Nigel, you know, the growth came up. It was a normalization growth in the first half. I think we will find that for this financial year, we expect to grow in the mid-teens. So somewhere around 11.5 million cases is around what we expect to end by end of this year.
Mid-teens growth,
which will still be significantly larger than the industry growth.
And the margins stay between this 12 to 13% band that you had earlier spoken about, right?
Yes, that's the kind of guidance which we are giving right now.
And this despite the gross margin pressures?
So in terms of commodities, Mangalam, we've seen easing in some of the commodities, but with the recent news with regard to the FCI, there could be some short-term pressures in the ENA pricing, which could have a downward effect on the margins. But through operating leverage as the company size increases, I believe we'll be able to offset some of that pressure.
So 12 to 13% margins with revenues of around 1,300 crores at least for this year?
Yes.
That should be the target. Okay. A quick other point, the market doesn't like when the promoter shares are pledged. I think there is some kind of pledge that is on your shares. Could you tell us, are you working on moving towards de-pledging this?
Yes, we are actively working on de-pledging this. I think it was function when companies undergo restructuring. I think the promoter pledge was consequent to that. But we have seen already the promoter pledge last year was 75%. It's come down to less than 25%. And I could give a guidance that in this financial year, we will extinguish that as well.
All right. Now, since you're in the mood for giving us guidances, let's talk about the non-South portfolio as well. You've said that 20-25% of your business in the next 5 years will come in from non-brandy. How much of that will come from non-South India in the next 3 to 4 years?
I think that's a difficult one, Mangalam. Difficult to give that guidance right now. We do have a major presence in South. We're a very strong company in manufacturing and distribution. So, yes, South will contribute the bulk of it. But, yes, we are investing in other geographies as well.
Okay. All right. Amit, thanks so much for stopping by a little early to have a swig on a Monday morning. But thanks for joining in and, livening up the mood. We're going to hold you to these numbers, though. 11.5 million cases, 1,300 crores of revenues, as well as margins at around 12 to around 13%. Good chat with you.